So, check this out. Mary and I went to a Goodwill outlet today.
Can you believe they have outlets for Goodwills?
They do. So the albums, I did the math and everything. I actually used to think it was 25 cents. It's actually a little cheaper. I have my receipt here. So at the outlets, everything's half price where a normal, you know, Goodwill would be. So it's not even 25 cents. Normal regular price is 47 cents for a record. So with the math, I got 34 records here. Half price of it was 23.5 cents per record. And we got a total of $7.99. So you spent
$7.99 for 34 records?
Yeah, which basically means I got to send you four. If I can just get even two good records that are keepers in here, which is
worth it.
A piece,
yeah.
You're good, right? And I think, now I'm playing this stuff in general. Like, honestly, there's a couple different ones, but for the most part, these are all. Like, if there was a funk edition of a vinyl video from me, like, this is the funk edition. Okay? And I need more of that stuff, too. So we're going to go through these records. I haven't really done too much homework. There's a couple I do know by their names. There's a couple most of them I don't. And the only thing I did with every one of them was, like, basically throw on the first track for, like, 10 seconds and then go boom, boom, boom across the side to see how it sounds in general. Okay, so let's start off. This is what you're listening to. I'm happy with this. This is sweet. I like this music. This is Southern Comfort from the Crusaders.
Oh, for a second I thought it said the Carpenters.
No, it's not the Carpenters. But this is baller. This is baller. This is from 74. Now, what I really liked about this and noticed right away, which I didn't know anything about, is my man Sequoia Flame showed this, and he was like showing this as a big thing for him. It's an ABC Blue Thumb. I looked it up and it's just a particular record label.
So is that thumbprint, that blue thumbprint right there?
Yep. So I don't know too much about like what they're known for in terms of if they're like maybe all their record releases are reputable. But my man Sequoia Flame, I got this because I thought of you. But I mean I like it. My first Crusaders album. It's a gatefold. Yeah, good stuff. And then, while I'm on the topic, I'm gonna ask a question. If you guys have ever seen that, I'm sure everyone has these double albums. Can somebody explain to me why there's some double albums where instead of having one record that says A side and B side, some of them are actually side A, side C, and the other record is side B, side B? That's a real pain for me. I don't really understand it too much. But here you go, Crusaders.
Good question.
It is, because I'm guessing it just may have to do with the amount, what the space is on the records for the groups.
Yeah, maybe so.
Okay, this is the one out of all of them, I'm probably like, I don't really care to have this too much. But I mean, let the record sell itself. Who wants this? You can have it. It's called, What Time Is It? And it is from Morris Day and the Time. I don't know. I just don't know how I'm gonna listen to it. The guys look silly, but it sort of sounds like Princey in a way.
It looks Princey too.
Yeah, and it does sound Princey. So it is what it is. But I like, you know what I just noticed for the first time?
What?
I like how in the background they're all chilling in front of a brick building. I didn't realize that they're all chilling outside the girls' restroom.
Ah! They're like all in line for the girls' restroom.
I don't think
or else
lying.
Wait, do you think they're waiting for
the
women?
Girls to come out, Mary.
Well,
such
you know.
Innocent mind.
Oh, shush.
Alright. Actually, you know what? I don't know how I missed this, but I didn't actually listen to this one. Actually, the reason why I didn't listen to this one is because I jumped to the next one, which I find very funny. But I've seen this before. I like the cover a lot, and I feel like hopefully it's good. I think it's a band. The band must be McKendree Spring. Yeah. It's on a Decca label, and it's pretty. It's really pretty with the clouds, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's called, the group is called McKendree Spring, and the record is called Tracks. And, it just looks like it's just a really nice picture, you know? I really enjoy it. I think, you know why I enjoy this? I wonder if you've ever been on a train that went through trees like that.
I have.
Really? I've never been on a train that went through trees. Every train I went on was like a subway train. So, I mean, I think I'm really turned on by that, actually. I just realized that. It's a really cool picture.
When we go to my parents' house, I'll take you on one. It's actually an old-school-looking train, too, like that.
A tree train?
Okay.
So, you know what I'm showing. I wanted to hear this so bad, and I just, like, had to play it, and I got it because of the sleeve alone. But, like, honestly, Mary wasn't here while I was going through all of this, but, like, this, she actually sounds really badass. I'm really a fan of this. So, this is a woman named Stacy Ladisaw, and I got it because the record sleeve was so amazing. It's called Sneaking Out, and I wish it was a gatefold so I can show you it all, but it's basically a picture. She's, like, almost like a babysitter, and so you had this little boy, this little black boy chilling where his feet aren't even touching the ground. He's like doing homework and he has his dog in a chair. And then it has like a picture of like the continuous photo is like her and she's just like leaving. So I thought it was really funny, you know, and the tracks are just fun. Like the colors are really nice and pinky and girly. And, I listened to the opening track called Seeking Out and it was just really sweet. I actually really thought it was pretty cool. So there you go. Oh, you guys, let me know what you know about this stuff. This is very interesting. I was very excited about this. This is a band called Lighthouse, and it's called Lighthouse Live. And when I listened to the opening track, well, here, it actually. It's a live recording of a concert they did at Carnegie Hall on February 6, 1972. Their first live album. And after hearing the opening track, they're actually a Canadian band. So all you guys from Canada, I'm sure you guys know who they are. And I never heard of them before, but it sounded like they were rocking out, and I'm intrigued. I am. And it's on Evolution Records. Man, we ain't getting started yet. Alright, this is cool. This guy's name is Lee Oscar. It's called Before the Rain, right? And I thought it was a very nice looking picture. You know, it's a painting. I enjoyed it. Backside, he's chilling on the bench. But here's what's cool. There's no lyrics on the album. He's a harmonica player. So all the music is him, like, doing his thing over music on harmonica. Mm. And you know what's so cool? If you can see this up here on the floor, it looks like it's a little belt. Can you guys see that belt?
Yeah.
But you know what it is?
What?
It's like a harmonica. It's like a harmonica tool belt.
Oh my god!
So the whole thing is like full of harmonicas.
So funny.
It's a cool shot though, because it has like him relaxing with like an apple in his hand, and it has his record sleeve of the record that we have right here on the bottom here.
Oh, nice.
Chair. So it's just a very modern looking piece of art. And it's like, it's him. Well, here, actually, wow. Okay, so check this out. This is awesome. Okay, I just put this together. Check this out. Okay, the back photo has a back view of him playing on the bench.
Uh-huh, a harmonica?
Yeah, right?
Yeah.
And this is the building, right?
Right.
The front view is him inside the building.
Looking at the back.
With the outside being him on the bench.
Oh, check that out. That's a really cool cover.
Is that awesome?
Wow.
Yeah.
Cool.
And I'm down with harmonica. So
wow.
I didn't notice that until now.
Just made that discovery live on camera.
Yeah. And it's on Elektra. You know, Elektra's a very big, well-known label. So the artwork is very impressive, actually, on its own. I still love the butterfly Elektra. And, I'm excited to hear some songs from here. Like, the last track is called Haunted House. The first song is called Feeling Happy. So, yeah, San Francisco Bay. This is cool. Maybe people know about this. Okay, Climax Blues Band. It's called Gold Plated. There's too much into it. It's a gatefold. It's an album of theirs. I just never heard these guys before, but it just sounded like they were just a really good rocking band. There's a pretty cool write-up on the back here. This is from 1976, and it's on Sire. And I'm pretty sure that Sire is same label that the Pretenders album, Pretenders 2 album is on. So, that's how I know Sire. Yeah, I'm excited about that harmonica record.
Yeah.
Okay, I saw this dude, I saw this for a while in Manifest on the shelf, and I just thought it would look funny. Papa John Creech, and the album is called Filthy. He looks kind of filthy, right?
He does.
Now, I opened it up and I listened to a track. You know what's funny? Because you would never expect this from this guy in this cover.
What?
He's a violin player.
Is he really?
Yeah, it's like
he's all pimped out on that cover.
Yeah, look, they're all in here. Here's your boy in the main box right here. And it's basically, it's like sort of like funky music, but he does violin parts over it.
Huh, interesting.
Yeah, I mean, you wouldn't expect it.
No.
He just looks like a pimp.
He does look like a pimp.
but you know, he's filthy. It's cool because he's chilling in a beach chair in like a junkyard.
Yep.
That's what I like about it. Now, most people know this. I just knew of this. When I saw it, it looked familiar. Mary, I thought you knew, but you didn't. The historic recording, We Are the World.
Well, I've heard of it. I just.
Song. You have?
Yeah, of course. Okay.
It's like USA for Africa. It's in perfect shape. It really is. The gable has all the pictures in there. I know there's
all the artists involved.
Yeah, like great. Even some people whose names aren't on the back on the actual artist tracks are in there. Like Stevie Wonder, Prince is on there, Michael Jackson, Bruce Springsteen, Ray Charles. Lots of people are in here. The album tracks themselves are like Chicago, Steve Perry, Prince, Bruce Springsteen, Tina Turner. But the popular song is the U.S. for Africa, We Are the World. Isn't that the popular song?
Nice. Yep.
The record's in perfect shape, has the original sleeve that came in, you know, so if you guys are interested, let me know, we can get you a copy of your own We Are the World t-shirt. Cool. Oh, it has lyrics on the back. No, it doesn't, just credits, but it's still original, so cool.
Awesome.
I never heard it, so. Seventh Wonder, an album called Thunder. There are a couple albums in here. I feel like you can never tell when it's a funky earlier stuff before disco,
mm-hmm.
and when it's disco.
Yeah.
Which is all good, but like, I'm not the biggest disco. If it's disco I get tired of is one thing, but if they're funky and they switch it up enough. Like, Zach made a comment recently about how like disco in theory and like what they actually can do can be really good, but then sometimes it's just way too cheesy.
Right.
So. You never know what you're gonna get, but I mean, it's a quarter. Like, all these records, there's no other shoes you can get.
No less than 25 cents. 23.5
cents. But look at your boys. Like, they're all hanging out, like, with, like, Egyptian costumes mm-hmm. on. So, I mean, that's funny. You guys should know that's sort of disco-ish, but you know what else is cool?
What?
The label it's on is called Chocolate City. Which is actually...
Upside down, babe. Oh, the label, okay.
Yeah, the label's on Chocolate City, and it's part of Casablanca.
Oh, okay.
So I was cool. There, right? And, you know, there's a couple records here that a guy made himself, the inner sleeve, so he put his own labels on them.
How much time you want this video to be?
I don't care. We can go
you don't
as
care?
Long as, you want
as long as you want?
If they want to watch, they watch.
I didn't know if you found out the max that your video can be for upload.
No, I suppose I can go on for like 5 hours. Okay.
Uh-oh.
Tom Scott and the LA Express. Now, that's an awesome cover.
Look at that.
It's Cats.
It is.
But not the Broadway show.
Right. Thank God.
But it was just kind of funky, like all the other stuff, you know? Funky rock stuff. It's on Ode Records. It is from... Not sure. But it's cool, right? Gil, I got this one with you in mind. You showed this as your record that, you know, changed your life. It's my first Phil Collins, so I'm doing it for you. Because it's kind of 80-ish sounding to me. Phil Collins. From Genesis, No Jacket Required, 1985.
Look at that red face.
I mean, I'll be honest with you, I mean, it is a really, really cool cover, you know? Got drip coming down his nose and everything. But, you know, let me know what some of your favorite songs are. I'll let you know. This one's a pretty sweet cover, too. This is like singer-songwriter type of stuff. This one isn't funky. Bobby Goldsboro, California Wine.
Purple drink.
Right, purple drink. And on the back side, it has it all done and stuff, and that's just some, like, trash juice, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
But singer-songwriter stuff, you know? I'll have to see how they like it. What's it on? Oh, United Artists, which is, it's a popular, I have other stuff that's on this, so. We're going, we're moving. Okay, I think this is going to be the best one. Like, I really do. And I thought so when I saw it, and then Mary said it looks pretty good. And, like, the dude sounds crazy. I don't even know what to say about it. You think it's Szobel or Szobel?
I don't know.
You know what? You know what?
What?
This is perfect. The record just ended. Stay here. Give him some little talk.
Give him some little talk. Hey, let's go look in the box and see how many more he's got left. Whoa! He's got quite a few left. I think we're about halfway through the stack.
What's
your
time?
Potty break. Please enjoy this intermission. Tim is really into this globe. This actually belongs to my roommate. But he says one of these days he's going to spin the globe and pick a spot somewhere not in the ocean.
Your boy does that in The Last King of Scotland.
We're
going to
hop on a plane.
He does it in The Last King of Scotland.
Oh.
That's how he ends up in Uganda.
Oh.
Which is another whole issue. Who knows about Coney, right?
Oh, I know.
Okay, so check this out. This is what you're listening to right now, okay? Where are we on time, by the way?
You're at about 16 and a half.
Oh, baby. Okay. Okay. Honestly, I'm going to be honest with you guys. This is the one I want to know the most. If there's any one record that I've heard from just a couple tracks that was the one I want you to remember that you'll see again, it is this one, okay? Because this record goes places in the first song. You'll tell. Now, the guy's name is Herman Szobel.
Uh-huh.
Herman Szobel. Now, the record's in perfect shape, right? Not only that, it's on Arista. It's a promotional copy. Roberta Flack writes something on the back.
Oh, nice.
Okay. So let's see. Herman Szobel has a unique approach to piano playing. It's called superior musicianship. He does not compromise quality, energy, or artistry at any level, and that alone makes him special in today's musical world. This album signals the beginning of a marvelous opportunity for the listener and lover of music to hear the difference between good and great music. Szobel's great. Thank you, Herman. I love you, Roberta Flack. Now, check this out. Your boy, what I like about this is when they show him playing in the studio, he's doing his piano with no shirt on.
Oh, check that out. It's not something you see every day.
You hear that change up there?
Yeah.
This is, I'm telling you, I have a feeling this is going to be the cream of the crop that's worth $8. So, pay attention to the background
awesome.
When you're watching these, okay?
We will.
Okay, most people know these guys. This is another one I'm excited about. He's a jazz guy here. Grover Washington Jr. Paradise.
Nice.
Really nice sleeve work.
He looks like a monk.
Yeah, he's a well-known dude. Pretty by himself. Very nice stuff from when I heard the first track, the title track. I'll try to push it along. Pockets, Take It On Up. This is another one that's sort of funky disco-like. But I like the pictures. This sleeve looks awesome to me. Steve Goodman, Sane and Private. I can't tell, but he looks like he's laying in like a half tub, half table.
Yeah, it looks like it.
It's on Asylum Records though, which is a label people seem to know. It has a lyric sleeve. It seemed a little not on my alley, but we'll see. I'll give it a spin. Let me know if someone wants it. Toto!
Oh my gosh!
Toto 4. If there's one Toto album I need that I'm ever gonna have, it's gonna be the one that has Africa on it.
Yeah.
I said, Mary, I said, you know this song, Africa!
Yeah, when I heard it, I knew it.
That is such a good tune. Like,
mm-hmm.
You can't deny this. The first part.
Awesome. Good find.
Okay. This guy I'm also excited about. This man is a beast. Orin Juice Jones. This one's for Henry. Orin Juice Jones, alright? Your boy looks serious. The record's called To Be Immortal. Look what he's doing in the back here. He's chilling in a graveyard. In a soup. In the nighttime. But it's funny because the title, the names of the tracks sound like hip hop tracks. But it's him like singing or like weird funky music. Money Honey. Pipe Dreams, Gangster Attitude, Never Say Goodbye, To Be Immortal. Side 2, Dollar and a Dream, Sacrifice, Shaniqua. Street Style, Time. Like, this is sick. And this is on, and it has a lyric sleeve and everything. It's on Columbia, and it has like a special Columbia with his initials on it.
Get down with your bad self.
Yeah. This is why everyone should hear right here. Freddie Hubbard, my first Freddie Hubbard.
Wow.
Music, like, hated on this album in the review.
Really?
My first one. Save. think they'll do this one either. Mother Factor. Called Mother's Finest on Epic Records. Again, people speak for themselves.
Oh my goodness, yes they do. They all been to Jamaica for vacation right before that too.
My first one from the Pointer Sisters, Priority.
There you go. It's
in great shape and it is also a promotional copy.
Mm-hmm. Hey, I have a stamp that looks like that on my desk.
Yeah,
this is Priority.
My man Lazarus, Dwayne, I know you love your promotional copies. So, here's some promotional for Pointer Sisters.
Awesome.
This one I was excited about. This actually sounded very good, too. This is promising. A band called Phase O and a song called Riding High. And I told Mary that what I loved about this was that it's on a record label called She, and I think it's like the coolest label. She with those eyes.
Yeah.
And the blue and the green.
Look at that.
Your boy Herman! Eddie Harris. I need some money! It's the opening song, and I love every minute of it. Eddie Harris, I need some money. Never listened to these guys before. Who likes them? Either Donna or Jess showed them. I think it might be Donna. Maybe Jess. Earth, Wind, and Fire. Gratitude. What?
My wrists are getting really tired. My arms are getting tired from holding the camera.
Fatback, my man Fatback Funk. Okay, this is called Fired Up and Kickin'. It's cool because each side has its own title with its own tracks. One side is called Free Party, the other side is called Foot Stoppin'. We're getting there. Another keeper, another great find. Chick Corea, the Leprechaun. On Polydor. And what's really cool is that this is a... No, that's not the one. Alright. Never heard of this guy. Looked interesting. Hank Crawford. Tico Rico. Sold him the title.
Nice.
My man, Jeff Reckerman, showed this just on his most recent video for Spacewalkers for Grecian Thunder Andreas. Tubular Bells. Mike Oldfield. My man Sequoia Flame loves this guy. He mentioned it in that video with him and his wife and the baby, which I showed you, right? Remember when the baby holds up that little sleeve with that crazy guy with the face paint on? Beautiful family.
I remember.
Ramsey Lewis, Love Notes.
Mm.
And guess who does this? Guess who does work with him on this on the first two tracks on each side?
Who?
Stevie Wonder.
Oh, awesome.
We're almost done. First Rod Stewart album. It doesn't have the original sleeve. I think the original sleeve made it look a lot cooler, but it's that cool thing with the glass.
Looks like a glass of whiskey.
Yeah, it's his first compilation record I found out. Sing It Again, Rod. You know, play off of Sing It Again, Sam, Casablanca.
Mm-hmm.
Mercury Records. Has Maggie May on it, has Reason to Believe. I got this guy because you guys won't believe this. I heard in the past that I had an uncle who was a really, really great musician, and I actually found one of his records today, alright? I couldn't get over it. He was an amazing bass player. The record's called Wide Receiver. My uncle's name is Michael Henderson.
Uh-huh.
That's so funny. He's supposed to be a real bomb. He's supposed to be dropping bass bombs on people. And he was actually on Buddha Records. I know you guys like Buddha. I mean, so just so you know, I got something in the bloodline.
Mm-hmm.
We're down to two, I think. This one sounded really good too. Never listened to this guy. Monk Montgomery, Reality. It's on Philadelphia. It's on Philadelphia International Record. Look at that guy. He looks promising, doesn't he?
Yep.
She's singing this. Yeah. Barcades, Light of Life, in the shrink wrap.
He's wearing my glasses, by the way.
They're bad, huh?
I think it's funny whenever you, like, tilt them down on the edge of your nose and, like, look over the top.
I
I'm doing it for the appearance.
Last but not least, I've been listening to this in the car and I didn't, but I found something that was really cool. I never heard of these guys. It's from it's a CD. It's from 1990 on Virgin Records. They're called The Vinyls.
Look at that! The Vinyls!
That was really cool. It's on Virgin. Mm-hmm. CD's in good shape. Song lyrics are inside the booklet. Song titles look cool. Make out alright. I touch myself. Lay your body down. Love school. Bless my soul. If love was a gun, need a lover. Bullet. Sounds like it's someone that, you know, a group called The Vinyls would write. Maybe people know about The Vinyls.
Hmm.
Cool. Guys, thanks for watching my first longer video.
And I apologize for the shaky camera at times. It was just getting a little laborious on my arms. But it's a good video. Next time I'll try to cap him at like 15 vinyls max.
Ready? Ready? The next video will be filmed at... Oh my god, you'll never believe it.
What?
It's Ireland.
Ireland! That's such a sign. I'm wanting to go to Ireland so bad. And it's St. Patrick's Day! Happy St. Patrick's Day, everybody.